Welcome back to another episode of Samsung Developers. I'm Vincent, here to walk you through the application states, transitions, and launching Tizen native applications. We'll go into detail as to what happens to your app from launching it, when it goes to the background and foreground, calling another app, up to its termination. So, let's get started. The flow of our application is determined by the callbacks, hence are responsible for changes in state. Every application starts with a request from the user to be launched. It can be either from the launcher or initiated by another application. The app create callback is executed, starting the main loop. The app is already in the created state. From the created state, for it to shift to the running state, the app resume callback is in charge of making the application visible. Since the app is up and running, it is visible and available for the user's demands. Two callbacks can affect the state. First is the app control callback. As you can see, this callback is also available in the created and paused states. This enables exchange of information, more so calling another app on top of it. This basically leaves the current app in the running state. Invoking the app pause callback can be caused by launching a requested application. The user wishes to go to the home screen or a higher priority event, or even triggering an alarm. In the pause state, the app is no longer visible to the user. As mentioned a while ago, the app control callback can affect this state. Calling the app resume callback sends the app to foreground and makes it visible for the user again. The last callback, app terminate, is responsible for terminating the event loop. It may be caused by an application request or even with the use of the low memory killer. The app is now terminated. For a larger picture of the callbacks and states, let's summarize the application framework. From the five states, it has corresponding transition handlers. In the application framework, we initialize the application first, calling the app create callback for its transition. Next is the main loop. This involves three callbacks, enabling it to switch between three states. And lastly, app termination, that was brought by the app terminate callback to the last state. Now that we know the application lifecycle, let's focus on launching an app. There's more to it than it seems. Recalling from the application states, the app control callback is involved in three states. First is that it contains the reason the application is launched. If the application is launched by the user from the launcher, the callback is empty. If the application, however, is launched by another application, of course the callback contains information. Now that it has content, the application is responsible for handling such. To help the application handle the callback, you can set the following information. Operation is the actions to be performed. URI is the data itself to be performed. MIME type is a specific type of URI. App ID is the ID of the application to be launched. And extra data provides extra information for the launch request and its result. Operation is mandatory information. The rest depends on the type of launch you would prefer for your application. First of which is the explicit launch. Here, the app ID is needed. Since you are setting a specific application, there might be a case that you don't have it installed into your device. You will get an app not found result. Here is a code snippet in calling the calculator into your current app. The other one is the implicit launch. Here, you would need to pass on the operation, URI, MIME type, or all three. The purpose of this is to choose eligible apps to handle the request. All parameters must match. In the case of a single match, the app is launched automatically, or else the user is prompted to select the preferred application. More often than not, we would like information from the app we called. This is where the extra data comes in. Tizen has predefined extra data keys at your disposal. But if you prefer to create your own, that won't be a problem. Keep in mind, though, that customized keys must be shared between two applications. Now let's wrap up this episode. The application states are ready, created, running, paused, and terminated. Callbacks are responsible to move from one state to another. Calling the app to launch can either be explicit or implicit, so directly specify it or offer parameters of similarity. The app control callback takes control of the flow of the app while it is in use. It enables information relay and, more importantly, launching one app from another. That's it for the native app fundamentals. I hope this gave you guys a deeper understanding of how native Tizen apps basically work. If you have any inquiries, go to, register, and log in to developer.samsung.com and at developer.tizen.org. Also, don't forget to give a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to the Samsung Developers channel. Thanks for watching.